support efforts to reduce the size and power of the federal government. Jason Setney.
When I ran last time, I talked about the oversized federal government. My first order of business when elected is downsizing the EPA by 75%, downsizing the BLM by 75%, downsizing the Department of Education by 75%. With the EPA, they will no longer be a regulatory agency. They will only advise the states. All 50 states have their own Department of Environmental Quality, like here in Wyoming. We meet the foundation of the standards that the EPA set before. Dealing with the Department of Education, the only thing they should be in charge of is college and university accreditation and dealing with grants. With BLM, that violates the Constitution. All land should be managed by the states. In downsizing these agencies, I think it's what we need to do. It's what we want here in Wyoming, and it's what's best for our state. Thank you.
Jason Setney, do you think that the issues such as marriage education, health care, and abortion should be under the authority of the states or federal government?
I believe all those are states' rights issues. I'm a pro-life heterosexual, so pertaining to the marriage and pertaining to abortion, I don't support either one. I believe marriage is between a man and a woman. If there's two consenting adults, it's between them and God when it comes to Judgment Day. I don't want to call it marriage. They can call it civil unions, whatever. That's their own freedom, as long as it's not infringing upon anybody else. Like I said, personally though, I believe marriage is between a man and a woman. Pertaining to education, I believe it should be at the local school board level. There needs to be a curriculum set up, kind of by the state, overseen by the state as a whole. A school board should have that leeway to come up with their own programs to do what's best for the industry and their own communities. Pertaining to healthcare, my first week in office, I'm going to repeal the Obamacare mandate or write legislation repealing the Obamacare mandate. Thank you.
Do you support state management of federal lands or transfer of title of federal lands to the state? Mr. Setney?
The federal government has basically proven that they failed at trying to manage everything. It should have never been done in the first place. Article 1, Section 8, Clause 17 of the Constitution said the only thing they're actually allowed to own is 10 square miles, which is the District of Columbia. In 1890, the land should have been turned over to Wyoming. I will fight so that all the land in Wyoming will be turned back over to the state, will be managed by the state. Because I think people like Representative Halverson knows what's going on in the northeastern part of the, or northwestern part of the state. They overreach. Somebody in a cubicle in Washington doesn't know what's going on out here. You look at all the beetle kill and everything else on these federal lands. Wildfires are getting a lot worse, and as a volunteer firefighter, we're going into that, and they're risking our lives because of their mismanagement. It should have never went to the federal level. It should have always been managed by the state. Thank you.
Our next question, will you support the repeal of Obamacare? Jason said that.
I believe Obamacare should be repealed. I actually have a plan. It's called the Health Care Freedom Act. If elected, I'm going to propose repealing the Obamacare mandate. It's kind of like a house of cards. You'll no longer have to face those penalties or anything else. Now, we've spent hundreds of millions of dollars on healthcare.gov, this healthcare exchange. I believe we actually should open that up to nationally and make it to where all health insurance providers have to participate. Now, it won't be managed by the federal government itself. It'll be contracted out through a government contractor. But in doing so, these premium prices that affect us here in Wyoming because we have such a low population, by doing it nationally, we're competing against people in California and New York, they'll be figured into that as well, lowering their premiums. There will also be a provision of this that says all healthcare providers must provide up front what it's going to cost you if you go in for the flu or anything else, much like a restaurant menu. Thank you.
Wilderness study areas, while the scenic river designations have a big impact on Wyoming way of life, how would you deal with the present areas future proposals for new areas. So we also include areas with wilderness characteristics. Jason Sebney?
We've seen all across the state, there's wilderness areas, wilderness study areas. There's actually a couple outside of Worland, I think the Honeycombs and Cedar Mountain. My personal opinion on this is the BLM actually needs downsized by about 75%. The funding actually needs to go back to the states, and then it needs to go to the local level where it can be managed locally. People in Worland knows what's best for the wilderness areas around Worland, not somebody in Cheyenne. While the funding's coming from Cheyenne, it's going to be trickled down to the local people for management. The problem with the federal government actually trying to manage these lands is they fail to do so. The BLM actually takes control at gunpoint in some cases, kicks people off land. We need to return it to the people around the local communities. This is where you chose to live. You're the ones best suited to manage the area. The WOTUS rule was something that this administration used to basically micromanage the people of the United States. We've seen firsthand what happens when the EPA gets involved with Andy Johnson down in Wyoming County, and if elected, I'm going to work to downsize the EPA by 75%. I said that earlier. In doing so, we can allow the Department of Environmental Quality to actually take control of situations like these. The EPA actually arrests people who violate these regulations. They actually have tactical teams with AR-15s and M-16s that will arrest people. It's just, the federal government has grown too big. This administration dictates whatever policy they want to. It affects water, it's affecting coal, it affects everything else. We need to get people like Obama out of office, support people like maybe Ted Cruz, who will stick to the Constitution and put the constitutionality back in the White House. If elected, I'm going to work with the Republican president to put a stop to the EPA's overreaching. Thank you.
Do you support changes to our immigration, refugee, and asylum programs? Yes.
I do believe in immigration reform, and I actually have a plan. If you go to my website, sydneyforwyoming.org, in that plan, it states we need to secure our southern border. That's the number one thing. We have over 200,000 veterans that are out of work right now. They're unemployed or they either just gave up searching for work. They have patrolling experience. We could put them to work with Border Patrol. It'll be an expedited academy, and they'll be back in work. They'll be contributing to their community, and they'll be contributing to the economy. We're in the 21st century. We have satellites and everything else. I believe in a GPS tracking system on anybody coming to this country for tourist reasons, H-1B visas, or if they're caught illegally, we deport them, and if they come back or they're going through the citizenship process, we put these trackers on. It'll give the NSA something else to do besides spying on or holding us all suspect. Thank you.
The next question is, what's your approach on gun control? I think we probably all know the answer. So I'm going to change the question just a little bit. I want to know your opinion on whether gun control is appropriate and to what level should gun ownership be regulated in the United States. Jason said.
Look, I'm a third generation Marine. I like guns. But I do believe in sensible gun control. Take the 5 to 10 minutes to do a background check. I'm surrounded by people on a regular basis. I work in corrections, I work in prison. I don't want any of those people to get guns or have the ability to get guns. There's some that may be okay, but the majority of them, the violent offenders, they shouldn't be able to get guns. It only takes 5 or 10 minutes for a background check. At gun shows, here's a phone number they can call. Take the 5 or 10 minutes. It keeps the guns out of those individuals we don't want them in. Now the Second Amendment, I'm a strong supporter of the Second Amendment. The reason that the Second Amendment is in place is to prevent tyranny. And I also believe that citizens that are safe and properly trained should have access to military-grade weapons. Plain and simple. It'll keep Washington honest. Thank you.
Jason?
Pertaining to Medicare, the biggest problem with Medicare is the feds have robbed it just like they have Social Security. I've seen actual reports where it'd be solvent through like 2070 or 2085 had they not touched that, had they left it in the account untouched like they're supposed to. Now, pertaining to Medicaid, in Wyoming, 85% of the people on Medicaid are either children, elderly, disabled, or veterans. That leaves only 15% of them that are actually able-bodied adults. And the problem with that is there's a lack of oversight. A lot of these social workers working in offices don't have the opportunity, because they're dealing with such big caseloads, to actually get out and see if that individual is gaming the system or not. If we had a few more social service workers, if they had smaller caseloads, they'd be able to get out and look for the people that are exploiting the system, which would deal with a lot of the Medicaid issues and a lot of the reservations against Medicaid, because a lot of us think about it as gaming the system, and it's not. The majority of the people actually need it, and I believe in social responsibility. Thank you.
Okay, well, we're into our last question. So we'll go from Senator Christensen to Charlie. Save it for last, because it's my favorite topic to discuss. So, and what would you like to see in ways of reform to the federal tax structure?
When I ran for the House in 2014, I proposed a national sales tax, and I still believe in that. I crunched the numbers, and it's going to bring in over $5 trillion at least. We need to basically tighten our belts, look at spending, but we also need to start paying down the national debt. Because all I see now is we continue to kick the can down the road and kick it down the road a little bit more. With this last omnibus spending bill, we're going to go over $20 trillion in debt, and that's just on the books. With the national sales tax, we'll be able to pay that down. We won't be screwing the next generation. We'll have to repeal the 16th Amendment. But in doing so, going with the national sales tax, we'll be able to become a successful nation. It'll do away with corporate taxes. It'll do away with the death tax. It'll do away with all business taxes. It'll do away with pretty much everything. It'll be at the final point of sale. So people like Charlie won't be paying taxes on the ingredients he's using in his pizzas. He'll be making all that money, whatever he's buying outside of work, you know, it'll be 12% up front, and then after 5 years, we'll look at what we brought in. Thank you.
Rex,
good job.
I like this. Well, gentlemen, that was our last question. Thank you very much for your response. One thing we can be rest assured of is we're a very conservative group. So now we'll have the opportunity for each one of the candidates. We'll have 4 minutes. It's 4 minutes. You can reply to anything that was said before. Talk about yourself, some more of your theories. It's your time. Please.
First, I want to thank Ron and Fred and the Washakie County Republican Party for putting this together. Mike, thank you for moderating. I also want to congratulate everybody on this stage. It takes a lot of courage to run for office. I learned that last time around. Being able to meet people and traveling across the state, listening to everyone's views, learning what it's like to be in the Wyoming community. Because it's not just Worland, it's not just Thermopolis, it's not Evanston, it's not Torrington. We're all one big community here. We're a lot different than the rest of the country. I also want to congratulate some of the people up here for seeing the light in their life and, you know, wisening up and moving to our great state. Growing up in Wyoming, you really learn what a sense of community is, whether it's the Friday night lights of football or church events, the fair, the parades, driving past people on the highway and just waving. I mean, we truly are one of the greatest states in our country. We have that sense of community that basically helps us put each other first. I've seen people in the state give the shirt off their back to another person. I've seen the humanity in this state. And at the end of the day, when we are facing adversity, such as the war on coal, various other things, wildfires, we all come together and we face those challenges. And to be able to have the opportunity to represent everybody in this room and everybody across this state is a dream of mine. It's the sense of community that made me join the Marine Corps. It's that sense of community that made me serve my state as a correctional officer, serve my community as a volunteer firefighter, and serve the state in the capacity as the Air Quality Small Business Compliance Advisory Panel. I was appointed by Governor Lee. It's an honor to do things like that for my community. And if you'll put your faith in me to go to Washington to fight for you, I think you want a Marine in Washington to do better and actually fight for the people of this great state. Someone who understands where you're coming from. Somebody who's lived here for the majority of their life and takes pride in representing the state. Thank you very much.
It's time to send somebody back to D.C. that's just meaner than a snake. And I have to say, I'm the toughest guy I know, and if I find anybody tougher than me, I'm going to vote for him. This is serious business. You are about to see Wyoming change, maybe forever.